pregame in District 14 5A. We followed them fairly closely all year long. And, of course, Nacogdoches Dragons winning a very tough East Texas district, that being 13 5A.
They certainly did. They were picked to finish sixth in the district. And second-year head coach Steve McCarty told me the kids just really came through for them. And on offense, they cheat a little bit. They start 12 seniors. And by that, they shoved the plays that were split in. So they have 12 seniors that start on offense and 9 that start on defense. And there's a lot of maturity there.
A very deep team, in fact, too. As we were looking before the game over on the sideline, they brought up just about their whole junior varsity roster in the white helmets. And, of course, the varsity players in the black helmets, as you can see there on the sideline with the pep group and the band in the background. If you see a white-helmeted youngster in there, that means he was on the junior varsity earlier this season. And the Temple Wildcats getting ready to come out of the tunnel. They are the visiting team here at Texas Stadium. Nacogdoches is the home team, and for the second game this afternoon, if you stick around with us, and we hope you do, Brian will be the home team and Marshall will be the visitors. And here come the Wildcats, 8-2 on the season. 8 wins, 2 losses, runners up in District 14-5A to the Bryan Vikings. The 2 losses this season to Bryan, and the last regular season ball game of the year to Killeen, that score was 14-7.
I believe that Temple probably brought more than their regular traveling roster is there. It's a very good contingent of fans from both schools here. I cannot estimate the crowd because I do know that this stadium holds 65,000, but I would say we're in the neighborhood of 25, 28, maybe 30,000 people here. It's a beautiful afternoon. It's about 58 degrees when we're going to kick off.
What were you telling me? That you thought this crowd is probably bigger than what SMU draws in?
Well, I don't want any SMU people to hear that, but I do know, being ranked the number 2 team in the nation, that they certainly do not draw at home like they should, but they've always had trouble drawing up in Dallas.
Well, we've got 2 of the best high school football teams in the state of Texas. Class 5A, the Temple Wildcats, perennial powers and perennially state-ranked year in and year out, and you just don't have playoffs in Texas unless Temple is in there. And because of that 2-team playoff rule this season, the Wildcats are back in their own home territory, you might say, the playoffs. And Temple done very well in years past. They lost the bi-district, or rather the regional playoff a year ago to Dallas Lake Highlands, and that game was up at Baylor Stadium in Waco. And of course, Lake Highlands went on to win or become the eventual state champion in Class 5A.
I don't know, but it looks to me like Nacogdoches. They remind me just a little bit, the uniforms of the Pittsburgh Steelers.
I was going to say that, but I thought I'd just leave enough alone.
I beat you too, but they really do. They're a good-looking bunch of kids. That's the first high school team I've seen, I believe, that has the exact type of uniforms, and they do resemble the Steelers. If they play like the Steelers, then Temple could be in for long afterwards.
Well, as you may note, Temple is going to kick off. Nacogdoches in the black and the gold. Temple in white. Nacogdoches won the toss. They are receiving. And deep for Nacogdoches, number 44, Mark Moore. There is the kick. And it comes high down to number 20, Hubert Douglas. Douglas with a football across the 20. He's got running room, past 3 tacklers, past the 40. Hubert Douglas, Albert Reese, the only man there, takes him down deep in Temple territory at the 39-yard line. But number 20, Hubert Douglas, he is the main man in the Nacogdoches starting offensive backfield. And Douglas takes the opening kickoff and takes it all the way down to the Temple 39-yard line, and that is where the Dragons will put it in play, 1st and 10. Take a look at it one more time.
Another look. We talked about this young man, Dynamite. There's Douglas cutting back. He's just breaking tackles. He will not go down. And there's 2 blue chippers right there, Albert Reese from Temple and Hubert Douglas, and he reminds me so much of a young man that played for Baylor several years back, Steve Beard.
The quarterback is number 9, Darrell Caldwell. Douglas, along with Terry Kegler in the backfield. I formation behind Douglas, further behind Caldwell. The give, Kegler. Terry Kegler straight up the middle across the 30-yard line, maybe down to about the 28. It is a gain of 11, and it is a first down for Nacogdoches. Starting defensively for the Temple Wildcats, at left end, Ty Hankerman, number 33, Julius Thomas, the left tackle, 74. Strong side linebacker, Kyle McQueen, 32. The nose guard is Chris Wilson, 67. Weak linebacker, Albert Reese, 88. Right tackle, Monty Sheffield, 79. Right end, Michael Pappas, 87. We'll finish it in just a moment. 1st and 10, Nacogdoches. Over the left side of the line goes Hubert Douglas, the tailback, and Douglas takes it down to the 25-yard line. Put down there by Monty Sheffield. The rest of the Temple defense, Boo Arnold, the strong safety, 31. David Hart, the free safety, number 44. James Ballard, the right cornerback, number 28.
I'll tell you one thing. thing. That kickoff really electrified the crowd. And after this next play, John, we'll try to get to the Nacogdoches offensive starter.
Wide to the near side comes Jerry Deckard. Again, I formation behind Caldwell. Caldwell handing off over the right side. No gain, Hubert Douglas. And there to wrap him up around the ankles, Michael Shepard and Ty Hankamer. No gain on the play, and it'll bring up third down. Butch, you've got the starting offense for the Dragons.
All right, tight end is Derek Lackey. The spit end will be Roy Rodriguez or Mark Moore. They alternate the plays in. Tackles are Clayton Shoemaker and Johnny Carter. The center is Ed Nichols. The guards are O'Neill Upshaw and Quincy Whitaker. The quarterback is Darrell Caldwell. The fullback is Perry Kegler. Tailback Hubert Douglas, and the flanker is Jerry Deckard.
It is third down, six to go for the Dragons. Again, out wide to the near side is Jerry Deckard. Caldwell wants to throw. Looking across the middle, going for the end zone. He's wide open, but he does not catch it. He went out bounds past the end line, but open was 83. Jerry Deckard, the split receiver. Unfortunately, the pass a bit too long. Boo Arnold covering defensively for the Wildcats, and he'll bring up fourth down and six from the Temple 25-yard line for Nacogdoches.
I don't know whether they will opt for the field goal or not, but their field goal man is number 75, Ricky Upshaw. His longest field goal of the year has been for 41 yards.
Well, from right here, it would be a 42-yarder, so that would top it by a yard if they elect to do so. And I don't think they're going to, Butch. I think they're going to go for it.
I bet they try to get the ball in the hands of Hubert Douglas, maybe some type of screen pass or a swing pass out of the
two back. Split receivers to the near side. It is fourth down and six. I formation. Now Douglas in motion to the far side. Caldwell on the rollout. Across the middle, the pass is complete to Jerry Deckard, the split receiver. And I believe it's going to be enough for an Nacogdoches first down. It is. James Ballard on the stop, but just a little bitty down and out on the play by Jerry Deckard. He hangs on to the football, and the Dragons have the
There's
first
Deckard
down.
Going, he goes down, just makes a little square out. The turning type, he got right past the sticks for the first down. And he is their leading receiver. He's averaging 18.4 yards every time he catches the football.
A gain of seven on fourth down and six. It is first down for Nacogdoches on the Temple 18-yard line. Again, Deckard wide to the near side, off your screen. Caldwell. Oh, and in the backfield. Nice play. Nice play by number 88, Albert Reese, the weak side linebacker. He was all over Hubert Douglas as he came to the football right when the quarterback handed off.
Let's take another look and see if we can... No, we did not get that on the replay. All right, we'll catch the next replay the next time around. Did not quite get that, but Albert Reese sure did penetrate that time, and he messed things up in the backfield. And there again, it brings up second and long, and they passed with great success. Like I say, the quarterback this year, Caldwell, is thrown for 15 touchdown passes.
A loss of two on the play, second and 12. Now, Douglas in motion to the near side. Caldwell back to throw across the middle. Deckard has the football inside the Temple 5. Down at the 4, number 20, Michael Shepard there to put him down. But a pass right on the money from Darrell Caldwell to Jerry Deckard across the middle.
There he is. It's just just kind of a look-in type pass, kind of across the middle, and he threw it right on the money. And when I talked to Coach McCarty earlier in the week, he told me the stats. I said, y'all must air it out quite a bit. And he said, yes, we do throw the football.
Well, they've thrown the football for a first down. First and goal to go for Nacogdoches on the Temple 4. Green, Hubert. Hubert Douglas inside the end zone, but there are flags on the play.
Had the right halfback from Nacogdoches. I thought he was moving, but now it looks like he may be against Temple.
Well, let's see. The Nacogdoches players are saying touchdown. We'll get the word from Dick Bates. Offsides Temple. It is declined. 6 points. Touchdown. Hubert Douglas, number 20, just taking the football. Straight power play over the right side of his offensive line. 4 yards. And a Nacogdoches score. They are on the scoreboard first, 6-0, with 8:32 to play in the first quarter. Here's the touchdown
play. One more look at that touchdown. It's just kind of a power play right there. And there's Douglas. I'm going to tell you, 5'4", 151 pounds. That young man is very strong. And of course, he is built close to the ground. Right, John?
Yeah, I'd say that's very true. And the extra point will be attempted by Ricky Upshaw, number 75. The kick is up. And the kick is good. With 8:32 to play in the first quarter, the Nacogdoches Dragons strike first blood here at Texas Stadium. Our score, 7-0 over Temple. Nacogdoches Dragons go 39 yards after the opening kickoff return by Hubert Douglas in eight plays to get on the scoreboard first here in the first quarter. Our score in Nacogdoches 7 and Temple nothing.
John Moore will have a little break before the kickoff. Let's acknowledge the officials this afternoon. They're from the Houston chapter. The referee is Dick Bates. Headlinesman is C.S. Pennywell. The umpire is John Talley. Line judge is Ken Masop, and the back judge is Mike Taylor. So these gentlemen traveled a long way up the highway to referee this football game.
All the way up I-45.
Yes, sir.
Nacogdoches set to kick off. To do the kicking, Ricky Upshaw, he kicked the point after. It is 7-0 Nacogdoches. Hubert Douglas scoring from 4 yards out for the Dragons to get the early lead on the scoreboard. And in deep receiving for Temple, 24, Vance Blunson. Blunson takes it at his own 12. Vance Blunson across the 25, out to the 28-yard line. And that is where the Wildcats will put it in play, first and 10. Starting offensively for the Temple Wildcats. The split end is Brian Hendricks, number 23. Quick tackle, Byron Farrell, 76. Quick guard is Desmond Royal, 68. The center is Randy Slicker, number 50. Strong guard, Preston Childers, 62. Strong tackle, Gil Gregory, 61. The tight end is Big Albert Reese, number 88. Wing back starting today, 44, David Hart. The running back, Vance Blunson, 24. It is first and 10 for Temple. The quarterback is Mraz. And taking the football, Vance Blunson around right end, picking up good yardage. He's put down by Bruce Arendt for Nacogdoches. And finishing out the starting offense for Temple, the fullback starting today is number 33. That is Ty Hankover. He and Kyle McQueen will alternate.
John, let's take another look at that. It was a power sweep that time. You see Blunson turning up behind, good blocking, turning up and picking up good yardage.
Todd Mraz, the quarterback, number 11, again, same play. Vance Blunson across the right side of the line, and he should have enough for a Temple first down on second down and two as he gets up to the 40-yard line before Patrick Dixon and Lorenzo Colston can put him down there. It is a first down for the Temple Wildcats, and, of course, we mentioned that Hankover getting the start today over Kyle McQueen at fullback. Those two young men alternate every other series. And the quarterback, number 11, Todd Mraz.
Temple has run two plays. Both of them have been student body right, so they are having good success with the sweeps right now.
At their own 39-yard line, first and 10 for the Wildcats. Full house backfield to give. Again to Blunson across the right side of the line, and Blunson again with good yardage as he's knocked out of bounds on the near side of the field by Ken Hall, number 24 for Nacogdoches. Butch, how about the Dragon defense?
All right, we're going to take another replay of that last play. You can see just kind of a crossbuck in the backfield. Number 24, Blunson ends up picking up good yardage. The defensive ends for Nacogdoches are Pat Dixon and Leo Berry. The tackles are Ricky Upshaw and Clayton Shoemaker. The nose guard is Keith Ayers. The linebacker is Shaq Matthews. Incidentally, his nickname is E.T. We'll finish in a minute.
Second down and two again for the Wildcats. Straight up the middle to give. First man through the hole is Hankover, the fullback. And Hankover close to the 49. And he will be close to a Temple first down. Actually, they're going to mark it at the 48. He'll be a half a yard shy. It'll bring up third down and less than one.
The other linebacker is Lorenzo Colston. The cornerbacks are Wesley Moore and Ken Hall. The strong safety is Bruce Aaron, and the free safety is Mark Moore. Keep an eye on that young man. He's an outstanding athlete.
As you get a look at the Temple Wildcat band, it is third down and less than one. And now switching over is 61. Strong tackle, Gil Gregory to the right side. That's where the play goes. Hankover with the football. He is across midfield for a Temple first down. Ty Hankover, the fullback, going over the strong side of his line. He's put down by Patrick Dixon, and the Wildcats come up with their second straight first down on their first series of the day.
Incidentally, Coach McCarty from Nacogdoches is a very good friend of Dr. Frank Cudlady, the Waco Independent School District Superintendent, as they were both at West Orange together. And he said, if I saw Dr. Cudlady, be sure and tell him hello.
First and 10 for Temple, ball at midfield. David Hart, wing back. And Hart carries the football into Nacogdoches territory across the 40, down to the 39, 38-yard line. And that time on the wing-back counter, David Hart taking the ball over the quick side of his offensive line to the 39, and a big opening there before Wesley Moore can put the stop on him.
Right now, Temple is having very good success running the football. They came out the first couple plays, ran wide with the sweeps, came back with the cross butt, then came back with the counter, and right now they're moving the ball very well.
Two wideouts to the near side of the field for Temple. Off the bottom of your screen, the give to Hart once again, and Hart maybe a yard in the middle of the line. And the first man to stop him there was 75, Ricky Upshaw, and Shag E.T. Matthews. And also on the stop, a gain of one. second down, or actually a gain of two, they'll call it. Second and eight now for Temple. And the just a ball inside the Nacogdoches 38-yard line.
Did you know that Nacogdoches and Lefton is the longest standing rivalry in the state in high school football circles as they played this year for the 60th straight year?
And of course, Texas high school football, a very rich history in itself. Hankamer, number 33, over the right side of the line, close to the 35-yard line before he is pushed back by Lorenzo Colston and again Ricky Upshaw. Just shy of the 35-yard line, it'll bring up third down and six for Temple. Third down and six. They need to get the ball just inside of the 30 for the first down.
This will be actually, John, their first third and long situation, so, and they have not thrown the football yet, so we'll see what happens.
To the left side, out wide is Brian Hendricks. In the slot is Blunson, hard in motion. Single setback, Hankamer. Mraz back to throw, going for it all across the middle. Pass is intercepted at the 14-yard line, coming across the field. 44, Mark Moore, and Moore still running with the football, cuts back across the midfield, and he is finally, no, he's still on his feet. He's finally jammed up inside the Temple 40-yard line, but the Temple receiver was still going straight down. Mraz trying to hit him at the 10-yard line, did not even see the football come to him. And Mark Moore right there on the spot. Butch, you called that one. That's one young man to look for.
Right. He's just a tremendous athlete. He's the 12th man on offense. He's 6'1", 180 pounds. We can see if we take another look at it. You see Mraz rolls to his left. His intended receiver was still going through his route, and there's Moore picks it off. And I want you to just take a look. I think the picture will speak for itself. He's a hard young man to bring down. Broke one tackle, breaks, misses another one. Broke another tackle, still on his feet, and finally down.
Back to live action. Caldwell on the rollout for the Dragons, going for the end zone. He's got a man there. It is touchdown. Nacogdoches, number 40. That is Roy Rodriguez, the end, split end for the Nacogdoches Dragons. And bingo, the Nacogdoches Dragons strike quickly off the arm of the quarterback, Darrell Caldwell, to Roy Rodriguez, number 40. And Nacogdoches again on the scoreboard.
We talked,
catch
talked
the tail end of the play.
Touchdown pass there. That I tell you what, they can strike very fast at any time because they do throw the football very well.
We've got a timeout on the field by the Dragons. One play, 40 yards on the pass from Darrell Caldwell to Roy Rodriguez, and he just slipped behind every single Temple defender and was open by about 5 yards as he angled for the end zone. The only question on the play was whether the ball would get there, and it was right on the mark.
I'm very impressed with Nacogdoches' ability to throw the football there. And I tell you what, they have an excellent football team. They are the smallest school enrollment-wise in their district. They have less than 1,500 students, which is very small for a 5A play. Let's see if we can get another look at that interception of Mark Moore from the end zone camera. There you see Mraz rolling out. He throws the ball. Moore just steps right in front of it, and now here he goes. You're going to see some excellent moves there. And everything they said about this young man is just tremendous. That he was a preseason blue chipper and a preseason high school All-American, and so far I haven't seen anything that would prove him wrong.
Ricky Upshaw, number 75, will be doing the kicking on the point after. 4:49 to play in the first quarter. Upshaw's kick is through, and the score now mounts to Nacogdoches 14 and Temple nothing, with 4 minutes, 49 seconds to play in the first quarter.
John, I'm having trouble hearing you. I think Kay needs to flick his button down there, because there we go. I hear everybody else, but I couldn't hear you.
Well, one play, 40 yards, Darrell Caldwell to Roy Rodriguez, and what can you say? It was a very, very well-executed play on the part of the Dragons.
It sure was, and but there again, Temple took the kickoff. Their first possession drove very well down the field, but when they were faced with third and long, they had to go to the air, and that's been one of their problems. We saw them earlier against Bryan this year, but it looked like either the quarterback or receiver won. Got a little confused because the receiver never did turn around. He was still going through his patterns.
It looked like he was even making a block on the play.
Right, so maybe, like I said, there might have been some confusion there. So, but I know Coach Bob McQueen's Wildcats, they're rich in tradition, and it's important now that they get something going, or this could turn into a wrap.
They did show they could move the football, but I think you're right. I can already see the parallel between this game and the Bryan game in Kyle Field at College Station a few weeks back for the Wildcats. They got behind late in the first quarter, and then things just seem to snowball on him. Well, right now, the snowball is starting to grow bigger. in this particular instance, and if they can take the football, move it down the field, and put something on the board, perhaps they can keep it from getting any bigger than it is. Upshaw with the kick. It comes short. Go to the far side of the field. It's taken by the upback for Temple. That is 28, James Ballard. And Ballard is stopped just short of the 30-yard line. And that is where the Wildcats will put it in play. First and 10, their own 29. Stop there made by Lorenzo Colston and Mark Moore, number 44.
Johnny caught that football right down but around between the 20 and the goal line on the left side of your screen. There's a sunspot there, and I bet it's pretty difficult because they have the hole in the roof here. But right now, I mean, I don't see the Temple needs to do anything different than they did on the first drive, except maybe stay out of the third and long situations if possible.
First and 10 for the Wildcats. David Hart out wide to the right side. Brian Hendricks to the far side. Draw play. Kyle McQueen starting fullback on this series, and McQueen rolls his way up to the 34-yard line. A gain of about 5 on the play. Second down and 5. Stopped there by Lorenzo Colston.
A little bit more about Mark Moore, number 44. Johnny, 6'1", 180 pounds. He's caught 13 passes for 4 touchdowns, 10 interceptions, returns punts, and kickoff.
Second and 5 for Temple. Pitch back. Blunson up close to the 40-yard line and close to a Temple first down. Student body right, as they might call it. Straight power play. Patrick Dixon, Keith Ayers, and Ricky Upshaw on the stop. It is close to a Temple first down. As a matter of fact, they may even have to measure, so they're going to bring the sticks in.
Coach Picardi has also told me they have very little depth at Nacogdoches. They start 12 seniors, like I said, on offense, and the key to their season is they've had no major injuries, none at all, and he says knock on wood. So
you get a look. It is short by about the length of the football. So it is third down and less than a yard for Temple on their own 39-yard line. They trail 14 to nothing with 4 minutes and 6 seconds to play in the first quarter here at Texas Stadium in Irving. Wide to the near side comes Brian Hendricks. Off the bottom of your screen, backs are split behind Ross. Third and less than a yard, option, give. And the ball was given to David Hart. Hart should have enough for a Temple first down. Shag Matthews on the stop, and it is a Temple Wildcat first down at their own 41-yard line.
There again, John, they're moving the ball sufficiently on the ground, and it looks like the key to it, they're going to have to make maybe 5 or 6 yards on the first down plays to keep everything, keep everything in perspective so they don't have to throw the football. They get a good look at the Temple band.
First and 10, Hart, and nothing doing. David Hart, pursuit catches up with him. Upshaw in there first on his back along with Keith Ayers. And David Hart taking a loss of a yard on the play, again trying a little bit of a wing back counter.
So no one will get upset at now. Just to take a look at the Temple band. It was not the Temple band, it was the Nacogdoches band. And right now the Temple band is quiet, and they're just waiting for something to happen so they can strike up the tune.
Second down and 11 for Temple. Two wideouts to the near side of the field. Hendricks and Blunson in motion is Hart. Braz looking to throw. And the pass is complete to David Hart on the near side in Nacogdoches territory. And I tell you what, Todd Braz had a tough time getting rid of that football because 55, Shag Matthews, was breathing on him heavily. See if we can watch it on the replay.
And at the time, Hart had gone in motion, way in motion, and turns up the field. And you can see that Mraz really got stuck as soon as he let go of the football by E.T. Shag Matthews.
That is a big play and a big first down for the Wildcats as David Hart takes the football all the way to the Nacogdoches 43. Again, first and 10 for Temple. This time, the receivers out to the far side of the field. The give is to Hart, and Hart maybe to the 40-yard line. Keith Ayers, and once again, Ricky Upshaw on the stop for the Dragons. A gain of 3, second down and 7. 2.5 minutes to play in the first quarter. Our score, if you just joined us here, Texas Stadium in Irving, Nacogdoches 14 and Temple nothing.
I'm going to tell you one thing. Ricky Upshaw, number 71, is a 218-pound senior, and he's been in on a lot of tackles. His counterpart is Clayton Shoemaker, and he weighs 231.
Roz, the give. Up the middle to the fullback, McQueen. Check that, Hankamer, 33, and Hankamer takes it inside the 40, to the 38-yard line. A gain of two on the play. It'll bring up third down and five for Temple. Third and five. Now, this is how far they reached the first time. Last time they had the football in their first offensive series of the game. And this is where the point through the interception on the third and six, I believe it was. So let's see what they can do on a third down and five. The receivers out wide are Hendricks and Blunson in the slot. Hart comes in motion. Maz looking to throw the football. Has a receiver across the middle. It is overthrown. David Hart on the near sideline. And I saw 23 Brian Hendricks open at the 15-yard line.
John, that is the same identical play that they ran on third down a while ago where Hart comes in motion. And that time Maz probably should have gone to a different receiver, as Hart was pretty well covered. And I can say number 23, Brian Hendricks, was wide open, kind of across the middle. But there again, it's hard to spot everybody when you got them coming down on you like that. We need to pause right here for station break. We'll be right back.
Back at Texas Stadium, the Temple Wildcats facing fourth down and five, and they have elected to kick the football away at the Nacogdoches 38. So back to punt will be Byron Farrell, number 76, and deep receiving Mark Moore for Nacogdoches, and it is a fake play. And with the football on the far sideline is Brian Hendricks, and Hendricks does not pick up the first down. Nacogdoches had that one pegged right off the bat as the snap never came back to Byron Farrell. And 23, Brian Hendricks took it, and he was put down by Leo Berry, and the Dragons come up with a football.
John, that play did not fool anybody. It was a well-deceived play, but evidently Nacogdoches has gone to school a little bit and done a good job as far as scouting Temple, because they had it, they read it very well.
It only picked up a yard on fourth and five, and so Nacogdoches has the football first and 10. They're on 37. Caldwell, the quarterback, to give, tailback, number 20, Hubert Douglas, and Douglas is nailed in the backfield by Chris Wilson, 67. He's the nose guard for the Wildcats, and he just beat the center and got inside and put Douglas down for a loss of a yard in the backfield.
Watch Chris Wilson coming in. I mean, as soon as Douglas got the football, he had him nailed. And, of course, Wilson is a junior, and he weighs 250 pounds, so a lot of beef up there.
He's going to be a good one. Stuck it down on 11 for Nacogdoches. Lone setback is Douglas. Pitch back comes to Douglas. Round right in, and the pursuit catches up to him. Kyle McQueen, number 32, the strong side linebacker there first. Douglas picking up maybe a couple of yards on the play. It'll bring up third down and nine from the 39.
Now, this definitely brings up a passing situation, and that is where Nacogdoches has been so dangerous so far today. Let's see how many passes they've... had 65 yards completion so far. Caldwell has completed three passes, and all of them have been for big gainers.
Third down, nine for Nacogdoches. Two split receivers on the near side. Wide out is Jerry Deckard. In motion is Douglas. Caldwell on the rollout has pressure, and he is taken down in the backfield. Ty Hankamer, the defensive...